Hello, fellow gardeners. Today I wanted to put the spotlight on one of our native plants, ironweed. That's this lovely, tall, purple plant in the back here. Ironweed is in the Vernonia genus. So there are several species native to New York. I thought this was one called New York ironweed, but I don't think it is. I've got some other ironweed in the back that I bought as New York ironweed, and this is different. It's been blooming for about a week now, and you can see some of the flowers are already done. This is a great plant for pollinators. Ironweed gets its name from its tough stems. And this particular plant, I started with one single stalk. And over the years, it's grown a little bit. And it does have these toothed leaves, which is another characteristic of ironweed, the family. And then the purple flowers. So these are small bunches of blooms. You can see a honeybee there. Now, ironweed, they like full sun. They actually prefer moist soil. So I've probably put this in a spot where I wanted something tall and purple, and maybe it's not the best spot for this. I was thinking this might actually be giant ironweed, and if it was in a moist spot, it could be 12, 14 feet tall. But I think it's about 7 or 8 feet. It's doing what I wanted it to do. I wanted something here by the purple front door, and that would be tall in this part of the bed, the back of the bed. Ironweed in the garden, as I said, it's good for pollinators. The bitter leaves are usually not attractive to things such as deer and rabbits and other herbivores that frequently invade our gardens. You might get about 6 weeks of bloom out of ironweed. So because it's so tall, especially this particular one, it would be a back of the border plant. Ironweeds are good for rain gardens, pollinator beds, big perennial borders, and native plantings, meadows. And I want to go check out some of our other ironweeds. So we'll be doing that in a minute. Here's another species of ironweed. This is narrowleaf ironweed. This is a particular cultivar that you can buy, and it's called Iron Butterfly. As you can see, it's not blooming yet, but it will have purple flowers like its relatives. This one is actually good for smaller gardens because it does stay more compact. It's probably only about 2 feet tall. And again, like its other ones in the family, it does like moist soils. So you would want to make sure it gets watered as you're establishing it. And full sun also. And here we are with a plant that I bought from a nursery that was labeled New York ironweed. So I believe this is the actual New York ironweed. And it is just starting to bloom. And you can see it still has very upright stems. I put in, I think, 5 different plants in this little bed here. This is another native pollinator bed I've been working on. But you can see, if we get in close, the individual flowers. So those are much loved by bees, pollinators, other pollinators, butterflies. And it is mid-August, so it's good for later summer color and food for the insects. Again, it's got a pretty thick stem. This is about 5 feet, 6 feet tall for the New York ironweed. And it will create a nice clump. They will seed a little bit. These will get fluffy, but your clumps are mostly going to expand out from the base of the plant by roots. And I'll do a wide shot just so you can see. This is a large border here, so it's behind some grass that I've got. There's an oak leaf hydrangea and our bee balm and a clematis, clambering clematis in the background. And it goes well with goldenrod. Pink and yellow look good together. But this is the ironweed family. So if you can add them to your garden, if you have space and moist soils, they will adapt to garden soils, but you may have to water them if we have a dry spell. All right, I just wanted to share with you one of my favorite native plants, and that is the ironweed. And here is another narrow leaf cultivar that I bought this summer and added to one of my pollinator beds. This is Plum Peachy. So it's not blooming yet. You can see the flowers are just starting to color up the buds. But again, narrow leaves, a nice sturdy stem. I bought two plants, so I hopefully will have a nice clump in a couple of years. I'm thinking maybe the narrow leaf ironweeds bloom later in the season. I know that iron butterfly blooms usually end of August into September. So that will extend our ironweed bloom time. And I think this is the last of the ironweeds I have in the garden. Well, I hope you've enjoyed the ironweed show and will find some to add to your garden, especially if you have a wet spot or a moist area. Ironweed is especially good for them. All right, have a good day.